We've got another induction this evening. This next induction is a true Arizona legend who's celebrating 20 years at the helm of his current band, the Peacemakers. Please watch this video for Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers.
Thank you for your high spirits, your positive vibrations, your good medicine. Here we are.
Please welcome from Tempe, Arizona, the Peacemakers.
I'm Rodger Clyne, founder of Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers, proudly from Arizona.
Hi, everybody. I'm P.H. Naffa. I'm drummer for Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers.
Hi, I'm Nick Skropas, bass player and Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers.
Hi, I'm Jim Dalton, lead guitarist, Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers.
The Refreshments were certainly the genesis of the Peacemakers. You know, we went from bar band banging around just ASU in Tucson to national stages pretty quickly.
And when I first got the record deal, I was like, man, this is it. I'm gonna be rich and famous.
And then had a video, and then we're in a bus, then had another video. And then we broke up.
We lost two members in our band, lost a record deal. We were like, what do we do? We don't want to go get jobs. Raj came up with the idea, said, hey, you know, my dad's got a ranch. Let's go hiking and kind of clear our heads and figure out what direction we want to go.
We both decided we were going to commit through hell or high water to keep going.
I'm not here not to do the impossible.
It was a call to independence, and we wanted to get out there and do it on our own.
Independent is key, and we've been that since our first issue, since Honky Tonk Union in 1999.
The Golden Merit in a honky tonk bar. They set their vows on the six-string steel guitar.
I didn't even know what the internet was back then, so when we got the number one, you know, Billboard number one internet for Honky Tonk Union, I think they called us up and they're like, who the hell are you guys? What's going on here? So, and that's all due to the fans.
We certainly wanted to be rooted in Arizona and celebrate that.
Something in the Arizona night.
Arizona night on Native Heart, specifically about the spell that Arizona puts on one should you open yourself up. Growing up at the Clyne Ranch, my grandfather and father played country, western storytelling stuff. When I turned into a teenager, I swore I would never pull on another pair of cowboy boots, and started rebelling with Lords of the New Church, the Sex Pistols. I brought both of those things together sort of by accident in my music, this love of punk rock and pure snotty rebellion. I've proudly put back on my cowboy boots, and I still lean very hard on my punk rock influences.
Raj and I just started as a duo, playing at Long Wong's and playing at Yucca Tap Room, and we've had a lot of different players come into the fold over the years, and you know, without their hard work and their, you know, their creative contributions, we wouldn't be here.
A roll call, yeah, the roll call of the Peacemakers from way back when to present. Jim Swafford, the responsible one that kept the schedules and did the booking. Then there was Daryl Iacard, the first bass player to step up.
And then Scotty Johnson, who was a guitar player for the Jim Blossoms, came in. So that was the first iteration of the Peacemakers.
Steve Larson was a huge fan, still am a huge fan of Dead Heart Workshop. He was a co-founder of that band. Then Danny White stepped in from Nashville.
And then Danny and Steve left, and we have our current lineup, which is Jim Dalton and Nick Skropas. Funny that the sirens are going off when I mention those guys.
It's been an amazing adventure, and I think every artist would probably say the same. It's not easy. It's a weird life way, but it's really, really great.
It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers.
There we go. Thank you, everybody. Hit me, P. This is gonna get messy. Inviting all of our members and amongst our founders, James Swafford, Scotty Johnson, Daryl Eichard, our original incarnation. Going way back to Long Wongs and Yucca Tap Room and lots of things that we don't remember together. Yeah. What song are we playing, by the way? Yes. Perfect timing. This is from Honky Tonk Union, the record we all did together 20 years ago. This is Never Thought. James Swafford, Daryl Eichardt, founders. I don't know if anybody else is showing up. Danny White? Steve Larson? These gentlemen are also co-founders. We all played on Honky Tonk Union, even if it was just for a moment, but Danny White still owes me a bottle of tequila because I finished this song between Austin and Phoenix when we were coming back from a gig there. So You gotta pay up, fucker. That's... He's like, you finish a song between Austin and Phoenix, and I will buy you a bottle of tequila. And I think that is yet outstanding, everybody. We're Danny White, I'm putting him on the spot. It's only been 22 years.
Tonight. It's going to get crazy.
Whatever, just tequila. Bring it on. This is West Texas Moon, about that adventure. Exits here, not because we wanted him to, but because the Gin Blossoms fucking got back together and we couldn't keep him in the Peacemakers. And that was a good thing for everybody. The Gin Blossoms got back together! Then we made a record called Americana.
I'm every upgrade. feeling dirty, cruel, or mean. Let a little more money make your conscience clear. The blood is on my hands, 'cause I've been down the money. I made up the plan. Blue eyes, white lies, straight teeth, and crooked soul. Steve Larson on the guitar, Danny White on the bass. We'll be right back. death my heart waits only for thee, Maria, Marie. Mi corazón pertenece ahora y siempre en vida o muerte solo a ti.
Thank you, Peacemakers. Muchas gracias.
I may have foolishly misspoken. Before we get to the jam, we haven't inducted Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers yet. It's as though that's what we're still here for. So, to present the induction tonight, please welcome Greg Ross to the stage.
Thank you. So one thing that's becoming really clear is I'm probably the least qualified person ever asked to present at this awards ceremony. So we brought in some support. So James, if you could please play the video.
I wish I could be there tonight to see you inducted into the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame, but I'm out on the road, as you are normally. I just want to say that you're a true original. I had never heard of cowboy punk before, and I think I might have coined that phrase. I'm not sure or not, but it was certainly something you were doing that I had never seen before, and it was totally original, and it still is. So I also want to thank you for helping out Solid Rock every single time when we have our pudding. You guys were there, and we really appreciate it. So, congratulations, and adios, amigo.
So the story of the Peacemakers is as inspirational as it's been unfair, as celebratory as it's been strenuous, and as rewarding as it's been hard-fought. Long gone are the days when FM radio and MTV could fuel a decent band with hairspray to fame and fortune. Today's bands like Dead Hot, Pistoleros, and many others, they've had to do it by winning one fan at a time with a great live show. And that's what we're here to honor tonight. So as you heard in the video earlier, the Peacemakers chose to do it their way. They got a lot of it right, and they continue to get some of it wrong, but they choose to play the game on their terms. Their evolution will continue without fear of failure, and instead they'll board the bus after every show, they'll grab a beer, and they'll toast to their independence as they head toward another town near you. So since joining the band more than 10 years ago, Jim Dalton has brought his own dynamic playing and writing to the band. While at the same time blending the influences from the four guitarists that preceded him with the utmost respect and attention to detail. The consistency, commitment, and chemistry he brings every night have been trademarks since day one. His personal connection to the audience is both remarkable and very special. Jim Dalton. So as with any great rock band, the rhythm section is the foundation. And for 16 years, fans have treasured the rich tones of Nick Skropas' bass. as well as his always reliable vocal harmonies. The bond on stage with PH is as tight today as it's been off the stage since they were kids growing up in Chicago. Although he did not invent the newsboy cap or the plaid shirt, he is responsible for the fashion craze that is simply known as Nick. So when I'm asked why we surround the stage at Circus Mexicus with over 700 people, the answer is very easy. And it is, have you seen PH Naffa play drums from 8 feet away? So PH, you're the envy of every musician who has wished they've had your stamina, your finesse, your power, your raw determination behind every drum kit night after night after night. For those who haven't seen PH play from the side or up close, you haven't seen what a world-class drummer and a committed bandmate looks like. And by the way, tickets to see PH from the VIP area go on sale in March. Rodger Clyne's swagger, charisma, charm, edict, his snottiness, his words, and relentless pledge that says tonight we are the only band that matters, sets the tone on stage to deliver everything they've got. If you're able to see through his bona fide rock star presence, you'll find somebody celebrating his calling and willing to share that journey with you on a nightly basis. The blank canvas he and his bandmates began painting 20 years ago has impacted many, and it resonates today for all the right reasons. So to Jim Swofford, Daryl Eichard, Scotty Johnson, Danny White, Steve Larson, as well as Jim, Nick, P, and Raj, your contributions go way beyond timeless recordings and unforgettable live shows. You've created a community, and that it represents good, it's genuine, and it's also really fun. So on behalf of the hundreds of people here tonight, those watching in your second home of Puerto Peñasco, and thousands more across the World Wide Web, we all welcome you to the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame.
I don't want to follow that at all. Thank you for being here tonight for this, and let's create a long-standing generational tradition for the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame together. So much gratitude I have to give to a spouse, and all these gentlemen whom I've traveled with, whom I've recorded with, whom I've bled with, have carried more than their fair share of water to this career, more than their fair share of weight, and they carried each other and me for so many miles and so many months and years. I'm honored to share this stage and this award with them. Thanks to you. They were then, they are now, they will ever be peacemakers. Every one of us has chosen a really freaky-ass life way to follow, and because we're here tonight, it's evidence that determination and that craziness was supported by people unseen here tonight. Every one of us has a long list to thank for getting us here and moving us forward from this moment. I'd like to take a moment and just thank a few. My mother, Cynthia. Thank you. My father, Doc, thank you. Love of my life, my soulmate, one whom I cannot do without, Elisa, thank you. And so obvious, should be first and most, but last but not least, understand that there is no resonance, there is no impact, there is no meaning for music without an audience, and you are that. Thank you. This is dedicated to you. Muchas gracias. I give up the mic.
First and foremost, I want to thank Rodger, PH, and Nick for inviting me into inviting this kid from Colorado into this wonderful music community. I can't believe it's been 10 years. I also want to thank our crew for working hard every night. It's unbelievable what they do. Chris, Steve, our drivers, Boots, Jim Coleman. And I have to thank my family for putting up with this crazy lifestyle we lead and always being gone. It's not easy. It's the hardest part of this job, being away from loved ones. Love you guys. And last but not least, I want to thank my mom, because when I was a little kid, she bought me a red Les Paul copy from Sears Roebuck catalog on one Christmas morning, and it was one of the greatest gifts I've ever received in my life. And here I am. Thank you, Peacemakers.
Thank you. First of all, you know, the vibration of life and the frequency that drives you where you end up in life is completely unpredictable. I came to Tempe, Arizona in 1998, and all I wanted to do was go back to Nashville after 90 days. And I ended up in Rodger Clyne's band for 6 years, and 3 records, and a live record. And thank you. You know, the fans make this band, they always have. And, you know, we pray for things to happen in our life, but we never really realize what we're praying for. But because of this band and because of that experience, I've met my beautiful, the love of my life, Shelley, and my 2 kids, who I'd like to thank tonight. Because I stayed in Phoenix, Arizona. And, you know, I'd like to thank my dad up there. He was a great singer, great guitar player. He taught me how to play guitar when I was 6 years old. My mom and all my family that supported me. And this band, always brothers, and the fans who make this again. Once again, thank you very much.
Ah, shut up. I don't know how to follow that.
I want to start by thanking the Arizona Music Hall of Fame for the nod. Thank you very much. It's amazing to be recognized for what we've done and what we are going to continue to do for the next 200 years. I want to thank each and every one of you guys for coming out and supporting us. You guys, without you, we are just playing with ourselves, basically. So I also want to thank each and every one of these guys on stage here tonight that I've shared so many stages with, bled and sweat and sometimes puked and all over the stages. These guys are amazing. I've learned so much from these guys, good and bad. I love you guys as friends and as brothers. Thank you. Last but not least, I want to thank my wife and my kids for putting up with my bullshit and my, sorry kids, I hope you're asleep right now, and our absences, you know, from all of the pivotal moments in the kids' lives and stuff like that. It's sad, but thank you. I love you too. See? I tell these guys, like, I always get all the dudes that are like, yeah! Point proven. I love you guys. Thank you so much.
Oh, God.
Oh, weird. Woo! I think these guys said it all. I thank my entire family. Thank these guys and our crew. And like these guys have been saying, thank you guys, everybody here, all the fans. Appreciate it. That's what makes this band. It's awesome. Thank you, guys. Cheers.
All right, we got some loot. This is to the band, Rodger Clyne and the Peacemakers. Nick Scropus. P.H. Naffa. Jim Dalton. Scotty Johnson. Daryl Eichard. Steve Larson. Danny White. Jim Swafford. Let's rock.